Very good morning, everyone. This is V. Vamshi Kumar, Assistant Professor in Chemistry, Department of Applied Sciences and Humanities, MVSN Engineering College. So in this lecture, I will talk about a few concepts of chemical fuels that are knocking, octane number and cetane number. Okay. So before jumping into the actual topic, say for example, in order to understand the knocking properties of any internal combustion engine, we must know what is happening in the combustion chamber. Then only we will understand the knocking, and after that we will understand the importance of octane and cetane ratings. So here I will talk about combustion engines first, followed by knocking and octane number, cetane number. Okay. So whenever we discuss about any automobile or like cars or cars, so what we do, we classify engines into two categories, that are petrol engines and diesel engines in general. Okay, so actually the petrol engine is known as spark ignition SI engine, and diesel engine is known as compression ignition CI engine. Okay, so in this lecture I will talk about both spark ignition and as well as compression ignition engines. Now when we see any ad about lubricants like servo lubricants or Castrol lubricants, they will see this type of animation there. So this is a main component in internal combustion chamber. Actually the entire combustion takes place here. So we have one piston which is moving up and down in the cylindrical one. Okay, so entire combustion will take place in this combustion chamber. Okay, and here you see the components of combustion chamber. So we have one small shaft which is rotating, and we have piston which is, I mean, with the rotation of the shaft, this piston will move up and down. And here we have two valves here. So one valve is intake valve, and you can see in the last diagram, so other valve is there, which is called as exhaust valve. And in between two valves, we have fuel injector as well as spark plug. So in general, you can see here, it is written as fuel injector here, but for SI engines, instead of fuel injector, we have spark plug. And for CI engines, I mean, for diesel engines, instead of spark plug, we have fuel injector here. So now coming to the basic mechanism of combustion engine. So when we see any ad about automobile, they will say that the engine is composed of four stroke engine. So let me talk about the four stroke involved in the combustion chamber. So initially, so here intake valve is there, and through this intake valve, this air and fuel are drawn into the combustion chamber. So in general, guys, this is a main combustion chamber. So initially, first petrol will be filled in the petrol tanker, and it will comes into the carburetor first. Actually, the main component of any combustion engine is the carburetor. So here carburetor will convert air and liquid fuel into gaseous fuel. Okay, so it will mix in a proper way that engine health is maintained properly. Okay, so here first from the petrol tank, fuel will comes into the carburetor, as well as air will also comes into the carburetor. So carburetor will mix air and fuel, that will convert the liquid fuel into gaseous fuel, and after that all this gaseous fuel and air mixture are drawn into the combustion chamber. So your shaft is rotating in a clockwise manner. So you can observe here, when clock, I mean the shaft is rotating in a clockwise manner, this piston will move up and down, just like when we go to any hospital, it's like injection. Okay, so here the first stroke involved in the combustion engine is intake stroke. So during the intake stroke, this intake valve is open, and air and fuel mixture in gaseous form is drawn into the combustion chamber. So this is the first stroke, intake stroke. So air and fuel mixture is drawn into the combustion chamber, and after that, when the shaft is moving like this, this piston will move up, that leads to compression of this air and fuel mixture. So here after the intake stroke, this valve will be closed. You can observe in the second diagram. So in the first diagram, the valve is open during the intake stroke because I am drawing air and fuel mixture into the combustion chamber, and after the intake stroke, this valve is automatically closed here. So here automatically closed, and I'm moving a piston upwards. So with this movement, the air and fuel mixture will be compressed. So this is known as compression stroke. And with the compression, the pressure of air and fuel mixture increases. With the increase in the pressure, the temperature increases. So at this point, a spark will ignite here. So with the spark, the entire fuel and air mixture will undergo combustion. So this ignition, this stroke is called as power stroke. So after the end of compression stroke, a spark is ignited, and with the ignition, this entire fuel and air mixture is undergoing combustion. So with the combustion, it produces some gases like carbon dioxide and other gases that leads to expansion, and it automatically, that gases, heavier gases will push this piston back into the position again. So because of this, it again expands. So and after this, this exhaust valve will be opened, then again piston will come up, and all these gases will go outside. So these are the four strokes. First one is intake stroke. So air and fuel mixture are drawn into the combustion chamber. And second one is compression stroke. After the intake stroke, the intake valve will be closed, and we are compressing air and fuel mixture so that we can raise the temperature of air and fuel mixture. And in the third part, in the third stroke, power stroke, after the compression, a spark is ignite the fuel, and that will undergo combustion. Okay, so because of combustion products, the volume is again expands in the combustion chamber, that will push the piston back. Okay, and after this, the piston will again go to the top, and at this point the exhaust valve will be opened, and all the combustion products will be escaped through this exhaust valve. Okay, so these are the main four strokes of internal combustion engine. Okay, and efficiency of any combustion engine or any fuel depends on few factors. So I will discuss the factors now. So now you see here, at the end of intake stroke, I'm taking the volume here. So here air and fuel mixture are drawn into the combustion chamber. So assume that the volume of this air and fuel mixture is V1 here. Okay. And after that, the intake valve is closed, and we are compressing air and fuel mixture here. So at the end of compression stroke, let the volume of air and fuel mixture will be V2. Okay, so that ratio between volume of air and fuel mixture at the end of compression intake stroke to the volume of air and fuel mixture at the end of compression stroke. So V2 by V1 is known as compression ratio. So I also wrote that here BDC by TDC. So here BDC means bottom dead center, and TDC means top dead center. So during the intake stroke, this piston will go down. So it will go down to the bottom dead center. This is the last part. This is the last point it can go. And at the end of compression stroke, it will come to the top dead center. So the ratio between bottom dead center volume and top dead center volume is known as compression ratio. Okay. So greater the compression ratio, and greater will be the efficiency of fuel or any petrol or diesel engine. So here guys, when it comes to compression ratio, for petrol engine, it varies from 8:1 to 12:1. And for diesel engines, the compression ratio varies from 14:1 to 23:1. So for petrol engines, say for example, the compression ratio varies from 8:1 to 12:1. So we have one car called Ferrari 458 Special, which has a higher compression ratio of 14:1. Okay. So when we see any racing cars, so in general, racing cars will have more compression ratio. So that compression ratio will be 14.7:1 here. Okay. So here, based on the compression ratio, the efficiency of fuel will depends. Okay. And guys, here we need to understand the topic here. The compression ratio has some limitations. So I will discuss now. So here what I'm doing, I'm compressing the fuel and air mixture so that the temperature of fuel and air mixture increases. So when I go beyond the compression ratio, when I exit the compression ratio, because of rising temperature, without any spark ignition, the fuel will automatically ignite. This point is known as critical compression ratio. So compression ratio at which fuel self ignites is called as critical compression ratio. So when we go to critical compression ratio, that leads to knocking. So you can see this video here. So you will see all four strokes of engine. So initially, in the first stroke, the air and fuel mixture are drawn into the combustion chamber, and after that it is compressed, it is ignited by spark, and after that this valve is opening, exhaust valve is opening, and we are sending all these exhausted gases to the environment. This is a basic concepts of internal combustion engine. Okay. So now, just now I talk about completion ratio. So your completion ratio is a ratio of volume of chamber at the end of intake stroke to the volume at the end of completion stroke. Now it can be defined in some other way also. So the ratio of volume of combustion chamber from its largest capacity to the smallest capacity. So largest capacity means when I draw in the intake stroke, when I draw the fuel, so it can be called as the largest capacity. And after that, when I compress the fuel and air mixture, it can be called as smallest capacity. So the volume of largest capacity to the smallest capacity of an internal combustion chamber can be called as completion ratio. So just now I told that CR ranges from 8:1 to 12:1 for petrol engine, and for diesel engine it is 14:1 to 23:1. Okay, and I also talked about critical completion ratio. So in general, that critical completion ratio will lead to knocking of engine. So you can see here this engine composed of four cylinders. So generally, when we see automobiles, even I don't know about all these things until and unless until I purchase a car. So many people ask me how many cylinders are there. So at that point, I didn't know what is meant by cylinders. Then I studied about all these cylinders. So in general, so look at the diagram. So we have four cylinders were there. Four internal combustion chambers were there. So with the increase in the cylinders, the capacity of any automobile engine increases. Here, this automobile composed of four cylinder engine. So you can see the diagram also here. You can see the picture of internal combustion engine also here. So this internal combustion engine composed of four cylinders. This increase in the cylinder will increase the efficiency of engine. Say for example, if I take four cylinders here, the horsepower will be nearly 300 hp, and it will goes to 60 speed within 4.9 seconds, like this. So if I increase the combustion volume as well as the number of cylinders, then I can increase the speed and efficiency of internal combustion engine. I mean to say speed in the sense I can increase the power of internal combustion engine. So you can see this animated video also. So now coming into the knocking here. So I said that when we go to critical completion ratio, the fuel will be ignited automatically. That leads to knocking, I said. So knocking means, let me tell you one small example. When bomb explodes, people will die. That will damage the property. So what happens? A bomb explodes and airwave will hit with a high speed. So it hit the airwave seat in such a way that the person is hit by some iron rod like kind of things. Okay. So in general, say for example, guys, you're toiling on a bike without helmet, say for example. So you're going at a 60 speed and you won't feel anything. You will feel the small breezes, air breezes. So you will enjoy the things. And when you go at 100 speed, so you will find some irritation on your face because of air waves are hitting your face there. And when you increase the speed from 100 to 1000 kilometer, then automatically your entire face will be damaged because the air waves are hitting with a high speed. It's just like the air waves are hitting you like some person is hitting you with an iron rod like this. So the same mechanism takes place here also. Okay. So the bomb technology as well as this internal combustion engine follows the same principle, but in the combustion chamber, it is called as controlled combustion. So we are controlling the entire things here. And in the bomb combustion, in any bomb combustion, it is uncontrolled combustion. So what happens here when bomb explodes? It liberates high amount of energy instantaneously, and that is dissipated around the surroundings. So it dissipates in a such a way that the air waves are hitting with a high speed, and that will enough to kill a person as well as to damage the property here. So the same mechanism I will explain in the internal combustion chamber. So here guys, you can see the diagram here. So at the end of compression stroke, the spark is ignited. So here and you can see the secondary unwanted flame also. So here when I compress the air and fuel mixture, the temperature will rise, sometimes will rise above ignition temperature of the fuel. So at this point, when temperature rises above the ignition temperature, that fuel and air mixture do not require any spark for ignition. Okay, so it will automatically ignite because the temperature is well beyond the ignition temperature of the fuel. So before the power stroke only, at the end of compression stroke, this fuel will automatically ignite, and at the entire instant time the entire fuel will undergo combustion. That leads to high amount of energy within the internal combustion chamber. So you can see one more diagram here so that you will understand properly. So you can see in the normal combustion, the spark is propagated in a proper manner. The spark is propagated and the ignition is propagated in a proper manner in the first diagram. And in the second diagram, when you see the spark is propagating as well as due to self-ignition, some energy, ignition is also propagating here. So because of this, the fuel, the last portion of fuel automatically ignites, and that waves will hit the internal combustion chamber with a high speed that leads to produce a sharp metallic sound that is known as knocking. You can see this animated one. In normal combustion, actually spark is igniting the fuel and that ignition is propagating throughout the chamber in a proper manner. And in this case, with the self ignition, and the entire fuel is burning instantaneously and the energy is dissipating in a combustion chamber. So you can see this part. So energy is dissipating, and because of this dissipation of energy, the air waves will hit the internal combustion chamber with a high speed that produces a sound called knocking. So knocking means it is a sharp rattling sound produced in the internal combustion engine due to immature ignition. I can say it is as pre-ignition of air and gasoline mixture. Now we can give one more definition for knocking. So you can see this, the presence of some constituents in gasoline used causes rate of oxidation become so great that the last portion of the fuel and air mixture gets ignited instantaneously, producing an explosive violence called knocking. So without spark ignition, the air and fuel mixture will ignite instantaneously. It is self-ignited because of high temperature. Okay, and that produces explosive violence is known as knocking here. And the effects of knocking are: knocking causes huge loss of energy and damage the piston as well as the cylinder, and that will lead to loss of efficiency of engine. Okay, so now main causes for knocking are: when we use straight chain paraffins, like say for example, if I use N-butane or N-hexane as my fuel, so straight chain alkanes will have low boiling point as well as low ignition temperature. So when I use this straight chain hydrocarbons, when I compress this air and fuel mixture, the temperature will go beyond ignition temperature of the fuel. That leads to self-ignition, and again that leads to the knocking here. So in general, straight chain paraffins have low ignition temperatures when compared with branched and aromatic things. So here what you can see the manner here. So straight chain paraffins will have more knocking property than branched chain, and after that we have cycloparaffins, olefins and aromatic compounds. So generally petrol is a mixture of straight chain and branched chain aliphatic paraffins. So here knocking can be minimized by adding anti-knocking agents like tetraethyl lead, isopentane, methyl tertiary butyl, etc. Okay, so in general guys, so earlier they used to add tetraethyl lead to reduce in knocking. So even tetraethyl lead also undergoes combustion that leads to give toxic gases like lead oxides. So that's why government banned this usage of tetraethyl lead in petrol. So when we go to any petrol pump, you will find petrol like ULP. You will find it as unleaded petrol. So that petrol do not compose any lead compounds for reducing knocking here. So instead of tetraethyl lead, nowadays we are using isopentane and methyl tertiary butyl, which always gives carbon dioxide and water on combustion. So and for this and knocking characteristics of any fuel can be determined by using octane number or octane rating. So here, just now in the last slide, I said that straight chain paraffins will have greater knocking property when compared with the branched chain paraffins, cycloparaffins, olefins, and aromatic compounds. So when I use a straight chain hydrocarbon as my fuel, then it produces greater knocking because it will have low boiling points as well as low ignition temperatures. So here, let me talk about octane number and octane rating here. So I'm taking two compounds, N-heptane and isooctane. N-heptane is a straight chain paraffin aliphatic compound, and isooctane is a branched one. So in general, this branched isooctane will have less knocking value, less knocking property than this straight chain one. You can see here, N-heptane will knock 100% and isooctane will knock 0%. So when we talk about anti-knocking property, the anti-knocking property of N-heptane is 0 and anti-knocking property of isooctane is 100%. So when I use pure isooctane as my fuel, as a gasoline, then there is no knocking there. There is no knocking because it will it has moderate ignition temperature as well as boiling point. And when we use N-heptane as a fuel, then it will knock 100%. It will produce more knocking when compared with isooctane there. So you can see here. So in N-heptane, anti-knocking value is 0. It causes 100% knocking, and isooctane knocking property is 0 and its anti-knocking value is 100. So it do not cause any knocking. Okay. So now what I will do here, I will take various compositions of N-heptane and isooctane, then I will measure the knocking properties of this compositions. You can see here what I'm doing here. Initially, I'm taking 100% isooctane, which means that 0% in heptane. That do not produce any knocking because I'm taking 100% isooctane. And down the table, what I'm doing, I'm reducing the percentage of isooctane and I'm increasing the percentage of N-heptane. So from top to bottom, the knocking value is increased. You can see at the bottom, we have 0% isooctane and 100% N-heptane that causes 100% knocking in the internal combustion engine. So I will tabulate all these things and I will take my fuel now. So I will take my fuel and I will measure the knocking property of the fuel, just like as I did it for this compositions. So say for example, so I'm taking the fuel, so knocking value of fuel under test, and comes around 30. Now what I will do, I will compare this 30 with the table now. So this is falling here. You can see 30, 30 are matching. Now I will see the composition of isooctane and N-heptane here. So composition of isooctane and N-heptane are 70 and 30. So that is producing same knocking property as a fuel under test. So I'm getting 30 here, 30 here. So the composition will be 70 and 30. Now octane number can be defined as the percentage of isooctane in the mixture of isooctane and N-heptane. So here 70 and 30 is there. So octane number of fuel can be determined as 70 because the percentage of isooctane in this case is 70. So octane number can be defined as the percentage of isooctane in the mixture of isooctane and N-heptane that has same knocking characteristics of the fuel under examination. So in this way we can determine the octane number. Now coming to the knocking in diesel engines. So in just now I said that while discussing about SI engines, so due to pre-ignition, these engines will knock, I said. And diesel engine have some different mechanisms. So in petrol engine, I said that there are four strokes were there: intake stroke, compression stroke, power stroke, followed by exhaust stroke. And in compression stroke, this is a different scenario. And in SI engine, during intake stroke, air and fuel mixture are drawn into the combustion chamber. So, but in diesel engine, we will draw only air into the combustion chamber first. So during intake stroke, only air is drawn into the combustion chamber. And in the second stroke, it is compressed. The air is compressed. So the air is compressed in a such a way that it produces high amount of high temperatures there. So the first stroke is intake stroke in diesel engine. So only air is drawn into the combustion chamber, and after that it is compressed. So at the end of compression stroke, so the fuel is injected in a fine particles. So fuel is injected in a fine particles. The temperature is so high that fine particle automatically converts into vapor, and the vapor will be self-ignited, and that leads to give high amount of energy in the combustion chamber that will push us the piston back again, and after that followed by exhaust stroke. So here the knocking in a diesel engine is due to ignition delay, whereas in the petrol engine it is due to pre-ignition, and in case of diesel engines it is due to ignition delay. So let me talk about ignition delay. So ignition delay means the time taken by the fuel to auto ignite after being injected into the engine cylinder, or else it can be defined in other ways also. So the ignition delay in diesel engine can be defined as the time interval between the start of injection and start of combustion. Say for example, this fuel is injected in as a fine particles. So immediately that fuel particle should turns into vapor. The vapor will undergo combustion there. So the time taken for the injection and the conversion of that liquid fuel into vapor particle can be called as ignition delay. Okay, so greater the ignition delay and greater will be the knocking here. So here and for assessing the quality of diesel, we need to use other term like octane number called as C10 number. So in octane number, I said that straight chain paraffins will have more knocking properties than branched or aromatic things. And in this diesel engine, I need to have low boiling point molecules, low boiling point hydrocarbon, so that immediately after the injection of fuel, that will turns into vapor, and that will leads to proper combustion of the fuel. So here n-hexadecane will have zero knocking properties. I mean, it is 100%, its anti-knocking properties 100. And aromatic compound like 2-methyl naphthalene, or else you can call it as alpha methyl naphthalene, which have greater boiling points as well as its knocking value is 100. So in a similar fashion, I can define C10 number as the percentage of C10, I mean n-hexadecane, in the mixture of C10 and 2-methyl naphthalene that will have same ignition characteristics or same knocking characteristics as diesel fuel under examination. So in case of octane number, I'm calling it as the percentage of isooctane present in the mixture of isooctane and n-heptane. And in case of C10 number, the percentage of C10, it is n-hexadecane in the mixture of C10 and 2-methyl naphthalene. Okay, so here C10 has very short ignition lag or ignition delay, both are same. So short ignition delay, hence its knocking properties are zero, and its knocking anti-knocking property is 100%, or else you can call it as C10 number as 100. And on the other hand, 2-methyl naphthalene has a long ignition delay, and hence its C10 number is taken as zero. Okay, so greater the C10 number and greater will be the efficiency of fuel, and it will reduce the knocking also. So greater the C10 number and less will be the knocking property. And some factors which is affecting the C10 number here. So N-alkanes will have low knocking characteristics, and it has more greater C10 numbers, followed by cycloalkanes, alkanes, branched alkanes and aromatic compounds. So in my case, I'm taking N-alkanes and aromatic compounds. So N-alkanes, it is C10 and alpha methyl naphthalene or 2-methyl naphthalene. Okay, and the straight chain alkanes have high ignition quality, whereas aromatic compounds will have poor ignition quality. So here guys, hydrocarbons which are poor, gasoline fuels are very good, diesel fuels. So in petrol engines, I'm going with the branched one, and in diesel engine, we are going with the linear orchids. Thank you.